We're looking at a very difficult thing to get out sometimes with some people, which is a front body wrap. So when he comes up underneath like this, this leaves me susceptible to a lot of stuff. Now, this is particularly problematic on a guy like him because he's so tall, he can bend my back by pulling in the lumbar and using the shoulder shot to drive me forward. So what I need to do is work expressing my hips back at the same time as I'm bringing my arms down. Let me break for a second. So that what I want to do is wrap my elbows at his elbow joints and go in a line like this. Now, sometimes we lock it out like this, but we want to make sure that you get the full motion downward. So we express it outward like that. So when he's got it like this, my first thing is to keep my space in here. And what I'm going to do is start my breaking. Now, this sometimes may take one or two shots as far as the punching down in order to cause the break. And once I get that, now what I'm going to do is secure. See, if I don't get this out of the way in time, he'll hook it. So, but in here, you'll notice how I brought my arm underneath there to capture him at the triceps. Now I've got this control. So that means I've got full body shots available to me. I've got full knee shots. I can step back and hit with a overhand, that sort of thing, and put him in a nice state. So if we go slower here again, so if you move your leg a little bit, and when we come down, again, this might take two or three straight line shots. So as my hips go back, my hands go forward, like that, and I work the control. Now he's got really long arms, so I may have to do that more than once. As I go through here, so even if he does capture that leg, so we'll turn this way, what I do is I bring the leg outside as I hook it. So you want to go beyond the reach of the fingers. So once that comes in, break it, clear space, and then bring your hips back into play. So again, like I said, I've got this setup. I also have the setup for the throat. So I go from here, I turn my hips in, and I'll keep this bound as I go through. And basically I'm working as a windmill or pulling down on these as I hip throw him over. Now in his particular case, I may do just a sweep or leg control. So in once we get to that control, I may just step to here and bind in this position and take a step outward and sweep backwards or roll him over the top. Because you have this lever system that I set up underneath the arms and I pull down here, that allows me a good lever for his base. It's a lot easier to do than if I kept it down here. I've got very little leverage and he can bend his elbows and he can keep his own strength. So I go up here underneath the arms, I've got a good lever system for throwing him. Now when we get somebody like Dave is really strong. So he is not as long-limbed, but he's definitely strong-limbed. So what we want to do, again, this is one of the ones where you definitely want to sit there and pop the hips back as much as you can and be a dead weight, like the kid who doesn't want to be picked up, get used to that. See, because now he's going to sit there and hold me. Now I can break out of that. That's the mentality, is that drop. So I'm going to drop back as I try to work this. Now, I may not be able to get this out on this guy. The closer he has you to his chest, the harder it is to break out. So what I do is I work the inside knees. So we'll break this for a second. So from here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to bump. We have this in Rebel Wing Chun where we bump the knee outward, and that exposes your uppercuts, that exposes grabs, that exposes your knee from the other side. Basically, we're opening up his center line on the base. So when I do that here, as an example, I'm coming up like this. I open this. Now I've got a clear control or clear strikes with the knees, whatever I want to do. I don't want to cross my own center line when I'm doing my knees. So when I try breaking this and it's not breaking, I bend him forward more by popping the knee out. And it's a hit, and that works now. You can see this, they're meant for each other. Pop. Okay. So what I try not to do is go here. If I try to bump this knee out with the opposite, he'll tilt me. It's an easy throw, it's an easy takedown on his end. He'll feel that. So I bump out here, which stabilizes my base, gives me something strong. It bends him forward, because anytime you expand the base like that, it drops him down to a new level. So now I'm in here, I'll still work this, but I'll tell you, he'll start releasing the hold once you start smacking the groin like this, and you start opening that up. Now you get the same thing. So basically on the break, I bring my hand up, trap the elbow on this side, or tricep, you'll feel that it dips right in here. And I'm gonna bring my leg back and pass him through. So again, I have all these strikes that I can work, or I can go over the top, release this at the last second, and just take this arm and snap it on the rotation. I just turn my hips over and bring the elbow down. Okay, so that's one way to get out of a guy who's really strong. As you're setting out here, you're trying to bring this down and bring them together. You pop that open, send the knee through if you need, grabs, whatever else, that brings their base down. Then you clear it, bind it, and hips in right away. The hips in is really important. Once I pass like this, I've got to get my hips in. Now I've got binding control. So when I've got this set up like this, if my hips are out, he just steps back, drops his own hips, and he works his elbows out. It's really easy for him. So what I want to do is stay up in here. Now it's really difficult because I'm starting to take him off his base. And I can sweep a leg if I want. Sweep a leg from the outside. Okay, go back out. And savate it, okay? That's it.